We never know what life has in store for us when we are born. We also don't know how our lived experiences will shape us. I never imagined that my upbringing would become a life on the road and in the fields, yet I really would not change anything about my life, as it really has shaped and lent perspective to my political, cultural, technical, and aesthetic self. Although I have my own take on who, what, and how these different aspects have developed and continue to develop in me, I wanted to ask those who know me best, my brothers, to lend their perspective about how they see these aspects in me.
Aesthetic, artistic side. We were rarely exposed to what most would call traditional artwork. However, I think we have all evolved in our own ability to appreciate the classic works, along with some of the great pieces that Miles has created. I know you keep an important place in your life for music. It interweaves many of the family activities that we participate in, and I think that feeling of togetherness and those memories might be why you enjoy it so much. Your appreciation for percussion has always been noted. However, from what I remember, your concentration on playing something correct made the playing seem somewhat mechanical at times.
I really must agree with my brother Ruben on my appreciation for music. It was rare to be working in the fields and not hear music in the background or an occasional self-proclaimed Vicente Fernandez singing in the distance. In many ways, it was actually music that kept us motivated and built the will for us to continue in oftentimes very grueling conditions. However, it was also developed by being out in the fields and seeing many bright colors everywhere you looked. Without romanticizing field labor, there is a beauty in being connected to nature in ways that many will never know. I agree with Cirilo that educators played a vital role in the development of my cultural self. I also believe that it was the endless sacrifices made by our parents to give us a better life that informed this development. At the same time, the constant negotiating of multiple identities discussed by Ruiz played a role as we migrated every year to the state of Michigan. Finally, I think it was also due to the many lessons and values and philosophies that we learned working in the fields. Haberman indicated that good teaching was going on anytime students were involved with issues they regard as vital concerns. This is something that we dealt with every single day working in the fields. I agree with Efrain about my detailed nature. I believe this is a critical skill when you work in the fields. And I do believe there is a benefit to being technical. But I think Radvich did a very good job of reminding us that there is a danger of sometimes being too technical or maybe being unaware of what our attention to the technical issues is doing for students and those around us.
Regarding the political and power dynamic, I think you always tend to favor the underdog, which makes a lot of sense since from the very day you were born, you were the underdog by being born pretty much in the middle of nowhere with no running water, no electricity. And I think mom had a little bit to do there too, but you came into this world pretty much by yourself with mom. So that kind of started the whole process.
I agree with Ramon that I favor the underdog. I believe my political outlook has been framed in the areas of justice and injustice by the many atrocities I've witnessed my family undergo. From seeing my mother being sprayed by a crop duster in Decatur, Michigan, to having my father carried away to a hospital from a heat stroke in Rock Falls, Illinois, to having my older brother cut off a portion of his finger as he was clipping onions in South Texas. My political outlook is one that has no room for cultural deficit ideologies. A political outlook where access to opportunity for all is indispensable and where the hindering of those opportunities is unacceptable.